au Tibet.
Yes, traditional. Yes.
Like a welcome or?
Yes, yes, welcome.
Oh, thank you.
This bring to you luck.
Okay.
We arrived to Tasinota Hotel. Kunga is our amazing guide. And the rest of the group preparing to enter the monastery.
Wow.
We'll see which monastery.
This is the debating philosophy yet.
Where?
Choose the Ganden Tribar from the top of the...
Hello dear friends, I am in Jonghang Temple Monastery in the center of Lhasa. This is the most famous and most important because here is one of the oldest statue of Buddha. One is thousands of years old, more than 2,000 years old. Everything is peaceful, very deep. There are amazing statues of Buddhas that inspire very deep spiritual feelings if you look at them. And this is how people here meditate. They meditate in front of these statues. After a big adventure, we are arriving in the entrance. It's a great day, and now we are climbing these huge stairs, you see here, to go to Potala.
Inside
Potala, the palace. The views are amazing. How do you feel, Nila, after climbing 1,000 stairs? Okay.
Without words.
Yes, it's better. Okay. We are entering now in the summer palace of Dalai Lama. In 5,000 meter altitude, and here are meditation caves of yogis. You can see here the entrance of a cave. Now they are not used anymore because of the political situation. Here yogis would sit 3 years, maybe more sometimes, with closed door, sealed, and they could not go out even if they wanted. Of course, there were people to take care of them, to give them some food and so on. And here the purpose was to get rid of the influence of the mind and find the truth. Because you can imagine, to stay 3 years in one cave, you have nothing to think about. Your mind will finish with all thinking, with all bothering. Because otherwise you cannot survive 3 years closed in the darkness.
Thank you.
It's a wonderful morning here in Tibet, and we are ready to continue our trip. Yesterday we slept here in a place near a river. I will show you now. And here there are hot springs also, so we had hot bath with salty water. And behind me are this kind of prayer flags. It's a place also of prayer. So here is where we were sleeping, and you see the steam of the hot bath. Very nice. This spiritual adventure that we call life, we take it more seriously. Maybe we name it the spiritual path. It is amazing to discover new things. In order to discover new things though, you need to live more, maybe to travel, to go in different places, to meet new people. Yes, a life lived in the couch in front of TV is not a life that can fulfill you. So I urge you to start living more, to do something new, dare to challenge yourself and to go forward and upwards. Namaste from this beautiful place.